Welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are going to discuss today a very, very important topic for class 10th, which is from essay 2. And this is a very, very important topic called arithmetic progression. This topic is important because this year itself, two questions have been asked in IIT, and this topic carry also one question in civil services. So this topic is very, very important for you because it will pay you post 10th as well. If you are going to take non-medical, then it will also be an integral part of class 11th syllabus, and also in IIT, and not only in IIT, but after the examination is over, or whenever you are thinking about becoming a civil servant or a bank PO or any other officer's grade exam, then there is a possibility that one question from this topic may come. So this is very, very important topic, isn't it? So let us begin today about this topic, and this topic is arithmetic progression. So first let me deal with what is progression. Progression is what? And why this is called arithmetic progression? What are the characteristics of arithmetic progression? So let me discuss about first sequence. Sequence is what? Sequence. What is sequence? Sequence is an arrangement of elements. Arrangement of elements under indefinite order called sequence. So sequence is nothing else but arrangement of elements in definite order. Suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I can write, then anybody can say what will be the next term. What will be the next term? That can be 6, right? What will be the next term? 7. Anybody can get it like this? You know, because we are writing here counting numbers. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So everybody knows that what will come after 6, what will come after 7, what will come after 8. The arrangement is, has a definite pattern. What is that? Every number is successor of the previous one. 7, then what will be successor of 7? 8. So next term will be 8. Similarly, if I can write here 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, then what will be the next term? Any one of you can tell me that next number would be 13. Why? Because each one of them differ by 2. The next term is 2 more than the previous term. That is 13. Something like that. I mean to say, if any numbers is written in this pattern, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, the next number would be 13. Anyone can say? If this is 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, what would be the next number? That can be 32. Why? Because numbers are multiple of 2. Each next term is twice of the previous term. And therefore, we can say like this. If I write 1, 4, 9, 16, then what will be the next number? Will you tell me what will be the next number? 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, 4 square has been written. So what will be the next? That will be 5 square. So 5 square will be 25. And like this. Then next will be 6 square. So the different type of rules are associated in each sequence. Not the same rule. Sometimes by adding a fixed term, we get the next term. Sometimes by multiplying a fixed term, we get the next term. Sometimes neither by adding nor by multiplying, but a special rule is there in which we can find the next term. So how many rules are there? We can't say. There can be infinite rules. It is depending upon the thinking of an individual that how many rules can be associated and how many types of series can be made, that is not finite at all. But you are fortunate. You have to study only one kind of sequence, that is called arithmetic sequence. And what kind of that sequence? That special type of sequence is a sequence in which the difference between two consecutive terms are same. That is second term minus first term, third term minus second term. Difference of these two is 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, like this. 5, 5, 5, 5, 5. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So like that. So it means you have to study and you have to know this type of sequence where the next term is obtained by adding a particular term in first, in previous term, right? So that is called arithmetic sequence. So this type of sequence is called different sequence. Few of them, these three are there, which is on the same pattern. And what is that pattern? That the difference of two consecutive terms are same. So arithmetic sequence. Arithmetic sequence. What is this? Sequence. What is this? If the difference of two consecutive terms of a sequence are equal, then sequence is said to be arithmetic sequence. Like 3, 8, 13, 18, 23, like this. What is the difference? 5. Second term minus first term is 5. That these two are differ by 5. These two also differ by 5. These two also differ by 5. And these two are also differ by 5. So if the difference of two consecutive terms are same, then sequence is said to be in AP, arithmetic sequence. That type of sequence is called arithmetic sequence. But we termed as arithmetic progression. So what is the term progression? And what is the meaning of this? Sequence and progression, are these two same? If not, then what is the difference between these two? So let me explain this. Here is a term called series. What is series? Series. If the term of sequence are being added together, they are called series. In Deepavali, you have seen, you are on your house, when you are lighting your house, you are decorating by series bulbs. What is that? One connected to others. In similar type, when one term connected to others, it will be a series. I mean to say, 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11, like this. A series. If terms of sequence 3 plus 8 plus 13 plus 18 plus this, like series. If I am writing here 5 plus 10 plus 15 plus 20, this is series. And progression is nothing else but sequence and series. Both the type of things are to be studied in progression. So arithmetic progression is nothing else but those type of things, arithmetic sequence or arithmetic series, that is called arithmetic progression. It may be sequence, it may be series. So AP is nothing else but sequence and series of arithmetic type. So that is arithmetic progression. So the same definition, arithmetic progression. If in any progression the difference of two consecutive terms are same, then that progression, that sequence is called in AP, arithmetic progression, shortly called AP, A for arithmetic, P for progression. And the difference is called common difference, right? Difference is called common difference. For example, if I ask what is the common difference? What is the common difference? The common difference of the following. Common difference of following. Following. 11, 16, 21, 30, 26, like this. This is the sequence. What is the difference here? Will you tell me what is the difference? Difference of this is 16 minus 11, that is 5. This is the difference. 16 minus 11 is 5. Or even you can find 21 minus 16 is 5. Or 26 minus 21 is 5. This is difference is constant. And that difference is called common difference. Common difference. Is denoted by D. It is denoted by D. D stands for common difference. Similarly, if I am taking another example, suppose 17, 27, 37, 47, like this. What is the common difference here? Common difference is difference between any two consecutive terms. That is 27 minus 17. What is that? 10. Right? 37 minus 27 is 10. Like this. So this is a common difference. Common difference is 10. Now, we have to know that if there is any other sequence like this, say 5 plus 12 plus 19 plus 26 like this, what is the difference here? 12 minus 5 is 7, or 19 minus 12 is 7, or 26 minus 19 is 7. Another example I can take 60, 54, and 48 and 42. What is the difference? Here difference is 54 minus 60, that is minus 6. Always you have to subtract second term minus first term. Second term minus first term. So difference is nothing else but second term minus first term, or third term minus second term, or fourth term minus third term, or fifth term minus fourth term, or you can say nth term minus n minus 1th term, right? So these are the difference. I hope you got it. Okay, so let me write about the sequence. What is that? In any sequence, if I have written here 11, what is this? This is first term of the sequence. This is the first term of the sequence. And 16 was what? Second term of the sequence. So if I would write here that if A be the first term, and D be the common difference, A be the first term and D be the common difference, then if A be the first term and D be the common difference, then AP will be, arithmetic progression will be what? That can be written as A first term. Second term must be D more than the first term because difference is D. Third term must be A plus twice D. Fourth term must be A plus 3D and like this. So first term, that is A. What is this first term? T1 stand for first term. T1 stand for first term. T2 stand for second term. T3 is third term. T4 is fourth term. In first term, coefficient of D was 0. D was not present. So coefficient of D was 0. In second term, what I have written here, that is A plus B. In that one, coefficient of D is 1. Here coefficient of D is 2. If there is 2, then coefficient of D is 1. If this is 3, then coefficient of D is 2. If this is 4, then coefficient of D is 3. Just one less than this number of terms, the coefficient of D is there. It means, in fourth term, coefficient of D is 3. In fifth term, coefficient of D will be 4. In tenth term, coefficient of D will be what? 9, huh? 9. And therefore, similarly, If I would write a plus n minus 1 into d, it is the coefficient of nth term. Coefficient of d would be n minus 1. Similar, right? Fourth term, then coefficient of d is 3. Third term, coefficient is 2. Second term, coefficient is 1. So, nth term, coefficient would be n minus 1. So, coefficient of nth term will be a plus n minus 1. So, this is a formula. Nth term of an AP will be a plus n minus 1 into d. Or, simply we can say, Tn is a plus n minus 1 into d. Tn stands for nth term. Nth term. A plus n minus 1 into d. Right? So nth term of an AP is a plus n minus 1 into d. What is a? A is first term. Where a is first term. And d is common difference. Common difference. And what is a number of terms? It can be 1, 2, 3, 4, any number of terms can be there. So d is number of term, n is number of terms, d is common difference. So will you remember this formula? Nth term of an AP is a plus n minus 1 into d. Often in some books or some teachers can refer this an. An means nth term. An. If a1, a2, a3 are the first term, a1 is the first term, a2 is the second term, a3 is the third term, then an is the nth term. So they can refer it as an, but the meaning is same. I referred here tn. Tn stands for nth term. Right? So that will come. Okay? Now, so we have learned one formula, that is tn. And what about this Tn? Try to understand Tn. We have learned this Tn. Tn is a plus n minus 1 into d. We have learned this. Okay? Now, what are the use of this formula? Try to understand. What are the use of this formula? What are the use of this formula? Tn. A plus n minus 1 into d. Suppose someone want to know, find the 53rd term of the sequence, right? Sequence is 7, 13, right? 7, 13, 19, 25, like this. You can't add this because difference is, what is difference? What is first term here? 7. What is the difference here? 13 minus 7, T2 minus T1, that is 6. And you have to write 53rd term. Means you cannot do it at 6 and 6 and 6 till 53rd term is over and 53rd term will come. Till you cannot add it 6, 6, 6, 6, it will take lot of time. You can, but it will take lot of time. To find those particular term directly, this formula will be helpful, right? How it will be helpful? Let me explain this. We know Tn term is what? Tn term is a plus n minus 1 into d. Tn term is a plus n minus 1 into d. So here we want 53rd term. So in place of n, I should write 53rd. And what is in place of A? That is 7. 53rd minus 1. And what is D? That is 6. So, I can write here 7 plus 52 into 6. That is 7 plus 6 to the 12, carry 1. 6, 5 is 30 plus 1, 31. And 312 plus 7 is 319. And that would be answer of this question, right? So we can find any term of the sequence, any term of the sequence, whether it is the first term, second term, third term, fourth term, like this. It will be also helpful to find that any particular term lies in the sequence or not. We can. So, how to, it will be helpful, try to understand. Let me give some another example and we will be able to find that. One more question I am going to consider here, that is question number 2. Find 117th term of the sequence 4 plus 4, 9, 14, 19, like this. Say, what is first term here? 4. What is D here? D is second term minus first term. That is 9 minus 4, that is 5. You can find the difference of any two term. It is not necessarily that you should find T2 minus T1 or D3 minus T2 or D4 minus T3. You can find difference of any two consecutive terms in the sequence. So 9 minus 4 is 5. Now we have to, we know that Tn is A plus N minus 1 into D. And we have to find which term? 117th term. So in place of N, I can put 117. And what is in place of A? That is 4. 4 plus 1, 1, 7 minus 1. And D is 5. That is 4 plus 1, 1, 6 into 5. That is 4 plus 5 and 118. Now 4 plus 5, it is 584. So that would be the answer, right? So we can find any number of terms, any terms, if the sequence has given some terms. What is the second use of this formula? Let me explain. I hope you got it. You can find any number of terms, provided you know what is the first term and what is the common difference. Now, let me explain the third use of this, other use of this formula. That is question number 3. Question is like this. 303 is a term of the sequence, of the following sequence. Sequence is what? 7, 15, 23, like this. This is the sequence given, you know, 23, then 31, then what will happen? We don't know. So we don't know whether 303 lying in that sequence or not. So what is the idea? The solution of this question is, let Tn term of the sequence, sequence is 303. We can assume that let Tn term, we don't know, and since we don't know, so there is only one option that we can assume it, that this is a particular number of terms, Tn term. Which term I don't know? 15th term, 17th term, 100th term, we don't know, but one thing we know, that it may be, if it is pertaining, it may be for some value of n, it will be a term of the sequence. So let me assume that Tn term of the sequence is 303. What is Tn term? What is formula of Tn term? A plus n minus 1 into d. Now, you know that A is what? Will you tell me? What is A? What is A? 7, na? Right? Na? 7. So A is 7. And what is D there? 15 minus 7. That is 8. What is Tn? We suppose Tn is 303, A is 7, N we don't know, but D we know 8. That is 303 is equal to 7 plus 8n minus 8. 303, 8n minus 1. 7 minus 8 is minus 1. Minus 1 will come this side. 304 is equal to 8n, and therefore n would be 304 upon 8. 8 can cancel this. What will be the value? It can be cancelled by 4. So 2 and 1, 5, 2. So 2 can cancel this also. Right now? 4, 7, 28. If I cancel with this, so 7 and 2, 4, 6. This can cancel further 38 times. Means 8 can cancel the whole one. 8, 3 are 24, 6 and 6, 4, 64. So 38 times. N is 38. It means we can say 38th term of this sequence is 303. And therefore, 303 is a member of this sequence. Okay? N is 38. It means 38th term of the sequence will be 303. I hope you got it. 38th term. Right? Okay. So, let us see one more question of this category. If I write here another question. 28, 25, 22. Age I can write here. Age minus 31 is in the following sequence. Following sequence minus 31. Age minus 31 is in the following sequence that we have to calculate. So what is A here? 28. What is B? Will you tell me? Second term minus first term. 25 minus 28, that is minus 3. The sequence is decreasing. We earlier discussed this. The sequence can be increasing, can be decreasing. D can be positive, D can be negative. Right now? So, D is minus 3. Again, we don't know whether this one is a part of the sequence or not. So, we can assume again. Let Tnth term, that is Nth term, of Tn term, Nth term of this above sequence is 31, minus 31. So I can put Tn is equal to minus 31. And what is the formula of Tn? A plus n minus 1 into t. That is minus 31. What is A? 28. N minus 1. What is D? D is minus 3. Minus 31. So it will be minus 3n plus 3 minus 31, and 28 will go this side, it will be also minus. And therefore minus 3n is equal to, this will be also negative, minus 62, and n is 62 by 3. Negative, negative, cancel. This is a fraction and n cannot be a fraction. N cannot be a fraction. That is minus 62 by 3. In sequence, it can be third term, fourth term, fifth term, seventh term, ninth term, but it cannot be 2½ term. It cannot be 3 by 4th term. So 62 by 3 is not an integral number, since 62 by 3 is not an integral number. Integral number, and therefore minus 31 is not a term of the above sequence. Right? This is what we have to say. So there is another use of this formula. I hope you got it. Right? Okay. Now, the next type of things we have to study here is suppose they have given you that fifth term of sequence question. If fifth term of an AP is 23, fifth term is 23, and